This COVID vaccine is most effective over time, new data says. For some, Johnson & Johnson's COVID-19 vaccine may be inferior. Besides the issue with boosters, its efficacy is deemed lower than mRNA vaccines. However, a new report found something unique. Findings suggested that J&J's product works better over time than mRNA vaccines. But before we continue, please like this video if you find this informative and subscribe to our channel for more interesting and informative content. Don't forget to click the bell icon too to get the latest updates. In the ACIP meeting on September 22, the CDC reported its findings of vaccine effectiveness in the U.S. All three vaccines with emergency use authorization were included. Each performed well in their own right in preventing hospitalization and severe disease. Yet J&J's product got a surprise for investigators. Let's start with mRNA vaccines by Pfizer and Moderna. Based on the data from the Supernova study, which looked at veterans between February and August 2021, Pfizer was 92% effective against hospitalization among age 18 to 64, while 77% among 65 years and older. Moderna showed good performance as well at 97% against hospitalization in age 18 to 64 years and 87% in age 65 and older. The study didn't find waning when Delta became dominant. But in the IV study, which looked at hospitalized adults between March and August in 18 states, waning was obvious in one mRNA vaccine. Pfizer scored 91% effective from 14 to 120 days after full vaccination. Then, it declined to 77% at 3 months or more after full vaccination. Moderna's vaccine, however, stayed between 92% and 93% as per that study. For individuals 65+, we saw significant declines in VE or vaccine effectiveness against infection during Delta for the mRNA products, said Ruth Link Giles, who helps lead the CDC's vaccine effectiveness team, according to CNN. Now, let's discuss J&J's performance. In the CDC report, J&J began quite low at 49% effective against symptomatic COVID across all ages. Surprisingly, the vaccine's effectiveness rose up to 56% around 150 days after full vaccination. That's about 5 months after getting the single shot. Recently, J&J announced that the two-dose version demonstrated 94% protection against COVID-19, 100% against severe disease, 94% against symptomatic COVID in the U.S., and 75% against symptomatic worldwide. What do you think about the new data regarding the Janssen vaccine? Is J&J back in action? Share your thoughts in the comment section. Till our next video, thanks for watching.